The president of the Fraternal Order of Police says one of the biggest issues facing the legal system in Marion County is what he calls the revolving door of criminal justice. At the same time, while more federal resources are on the way, the feds alone cannot solve the problem.
It doesn't matter how many people we arrest, it doesn't matter how many talks that we have, if we are allowing criminals that are victimizing our communities right back out onto the streets, we will never make any progress.
From the steps of the White House earlier this month to here in Indianapolis,
this is a huge red flag.
Rick Snyder has repeatedly voiced frustration about how IMPD officers repeatedly arrest people for violent crimes, only to see them released from jail just days later.
Overall in our country, crime is going down, but in our major cities, it's surging. It's because we have these broken systems in place.
One example, in August, police were called to this street on a report of shots fired. Police arrested 20-year-old Tana Johnson with felony criminal recklessness after he admitted to pulling the trigger. 3 months later, here on LaSalle, while out on bond, Johnson was arrested a second time and charged with shooting at multiple homes. According to court records, during that arrest, Johnson told police, "It's all right, I'll be out by the morning." Less than a week later, Johnson was in fact released from jail on a $150 cash bond before being arrested again on an active warrant last week. On Monday, Snyder joined United States Attorney Josh Minkler, who promised additional federal resources will expand federal prosecution of repeat violent offenders.
This is new. Many of these crimes have never been prosecuted in federal court to this extent before.
At some point, the federal partners, they can only do so much. They can't just change our local system, but they can bring attention to it.
As for Johnson's case, he remains behind bars tonight at the Marion County Jail. He's being held without bond. Jesse Wells, CBS 4 News.